The New York Yankees are the most heralded sports organization in the history of professional athletics. The team has won 27 World Series championships and 40 American League pennants. Both are major league records that more than likely will never be broken. The organization has gained worldwide popularity, having 43 players and 12 managers in the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown, New York. Most recently, manager Joe Torre. What most people don't know is that the organization actually began as the Baltimore Orioles and moved to New York in 1903. The new owners built a ball field known as Hilltop Park. Since it sat on one of the highest points in Manhattan, the nickname of the Highlanders was chosen as the club's name. In their early years, the ball club dealt with a number of issues that hindered their play on the field, and as a result, were a losing team. That all changed in 1915 when the team was sold to beer magnate Jacob Rupert and officially changed its name to the New York Yankees. Rupert began to rebuild the team piece by piece, starting with manager Miller Huggins. However, the team didn't take off until they signed the great Babe Ruth. As a Yankee, Babe Ruth hit 659 home runs, 714 in total, which is a team record. He is second in club history with 1,978 RBI and accumulated 2,518 hits, third on the team's all-time list. In 1921, the team bought a plot of land in the Bronx and the construction of Yankee Stadium began. Yankee Stadium's inaugural game was played on April 18, 1923. Ruth hit a home run in the new stadium, which from then on became known as the house that Ruth built. Another of the team's key acquisitions was a native New Yorker named Lou Gehrig, also known as the Iron Horse. He played in 2,130 consecutive games, a record that stood for 56 years and was broken by Cal Ripken Jr. The Yankees won three world championships under Miller Huggins, and the Yankees lineup in the 1927 season would feature Ruth, Gehrig, Lazzari, Musial, and Combs was known as the Murderer's Row and is arguably one of the greatest teams in baseball history. Miller Huggins died in 1929. The following year, the Yankees hired Joe McCarthy to manage the team. McCarthy managed from 1932 to 1943. In 1932, McCarthy's Yankees returned to the top of the AL and won 107 games. They met the Chicago Cubs in the World Series and swept them in four games to win the championship. The 1936 season marked the first for the Yankee Clipper, Joe DiMaggio. He and Lou Gehrig led the team to championships in 1936 and 1937. In 1939, the Yankees lost the services of Gehrig, who was diagnosed with amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease. He died 2 years later. Joe DiMaggio went on to have a great career, culminated by his 56-game hitting streak in 1941, a streak that will never be broken. Joe McCarthy retired in 1943 and led the Yankees to seven World Series championships. Casey Stengel, the great professor, managed the team from 1949 to 1960. He was a good player that became a great manager. 1951 saw the great DiMaggio retire and also marked the arrival of the Oklahoma Kid, Mickey Mantle, who was one of several new stars that would continue the tradition. Led by players like Mantle, pitcher Whitey Ford, Yogi Berra, Stengel's teams won 10 pennants and 7 World Series titles during his tenure. Yogi Berra is one of the most beloved Yankee players ever and is 88 years young. 1961 would prove to be one of the most memorable seasons in Yankee history. Throughout the summer, Mantle and Maris hit home runs at record pace as they both chased Babe Ruth's single season home run record of 60. The media and the fans began referring to the duo as the M&M Boys. Maris broke the record with 61 home runs. From 1965 to 1972, the team experienced a steep decline, and the owners of the club, CBS, sold to a young upstart named George Steinbrenner. George Steinbrenner passed away in 2010, but was one of the greatest Yankee owners ever. He brought the tradition of winning back to the Bronx and was the father of free agency. Steinbrenner signed star pitcher Jim Catfish Hunter away from the Oakland A's midway through the 1975 season. And the boss made another terrific move, hiring former Yankee second baseman Billy Martin as manager. With Martin at the helm, the Yankees reached the 1976 ALCS, their first postseason appearance since the 1964 World Series. They made it to the World Series that year, but lost to the Cincinnati Reds, the famed Big Red Machine. However, the table for success was set. Steinbrenner continued his buying of high-priced free agents by signing star outfielder Reggie Jackson, and along with the Yankee greats Thurman Munson, Lou Piniella, Bucky Dent, Greg Nettles, and Chris Chambliss, won the World Series in 1977 and 1978. The highlight of those teams being Game 6 of the 1977 World Series, when Reggie Jackson hit 3 home runs in one game, earning himself the nickname of Mr. October. Billy Martin was the most beloved of all the Yankee managers due to his will to win and feisty demeanor. He was hired and fired 5 times and won 2 World Series championships. The biggest tragedy of the era was the death of Yankees catcher and team captain Thurman Munson, who was killed in a plane crash. The team struggled from 1982 to 1995 and did not make the postseason, but a new dynasty was on the horizon. Shaking it up once again, Steinbrenner hired Joe Torre to manage the team. He also brought in Don Zimmer as the bench coach and former Yankee pitching star Mel Stottlemyre as the pitching coach. Torre's managerial tenure was by far the longest under George Steinbrenner's ownership. Under Torre, the team won 4 World Series championships, led by the modern-day greats Derek Jeter, the only Yankee to get 3,000 hits, Bernie Williams, Jorge Posada, the MLB all-time saves leader, the great Mariano Rivera, Paul O'Neill, Andy Pettitte, and countless others. In 2008, they tore down the old Yankee Stadium and built a brand new stadium right across the street. The Yankees rewarded their fans in 2009 by winning their 27th World Series championship under the leadership of Joe Girardi and the heroics of Alex Rodriguez, who has 654 career home runs, Hideki Matsui, the World Series MVP, and of course, the core four, Jeter, Posada, Pettitte, and Mariano Rivera. Hopefully, we'll win again in 2014.